Welcome back, everyone. This is Jeffrey Reynolds from Reynolds Runabouts. In this episode, I'm going to remove the deck hardware and any of the running gear, power equipment, things that, you know, the motor needed or the shifter. The owner has decided that she would like to have me also do the deck and just scuff up the inside and then revarnish it. It does not need a lot of work. The rest of it, including the deck, is going to get a light sanding, and then the see where we're at. Try to get this deck so the tone is even. Going to go ahead and pop the probably FAMO wood was put in over the fastener holes. I'm going to pop that out and try to match it better with some FAMO wood that I use on the side, and we will have, I hope, a better looking all over boat where the mahogany stains are matching and the varnish will be refreshed all over the boat. So, time to get to work. So I've decided to go ahead and start sanding on the deck and the sideboards. And one of the first things I always do is look at the bung, if it's a true bung, if not, the filler. And this is filler. Looks like it might have been white when I take off the, did some sanding and it turns out to be white. I'm going to use FAMO wood, which has a mahogany that'll be a little darker. So. And if it's too dark, I'll start looking at FAMO wood that, you know, matches my deck and stain altogether. You don't have to be married to mahogany, FAMO wood, or any other filler. I even tried some cedar, but it was a little bit too brown, so I decided to try the mahogany. That seemed to be a good match. To do to clean out the with bungs, you can take an awl or an ice pick. And you can go right in the middle, and usually they'll pop. You can pop them right up. With filler, I take a fuller countersink bit, and I take it all the way up. So I leave a little bit of a tip on there, and then I put it right in the middle because it's important. Because this will give you a clean perimeter, and it not only helps you get the filler out faster, but it also makes a nice cut into the deck. So that the varnish, which is really thick, will have a tendency to hold on to that filler and want to break out the wood around the hole, which makes it look ragged when you go to put filler in, stain, or anything else. So this way, it allows you to put in a really nice, like right there, I've cut the varnish, I've cut the stain, and I've gotten right into the hole. And if you get it right in the middle of that bung, which is not too hard to do, that just the tip of that fuller bit will ride down into, and these are Phillips heads, so that's, or Frierson even, who knows. So that helps a lot. If it was a slot, it still should hit the slot, but you know, maybe not as easy. So I'm going to go ahead and do all of these, and then I go back with my pick and I gently go around it, because again, I'm trying to preserve that wood. And I don't want to make that hole ragged. And then I'll hit it with a vacuum and clean that out and then just pick away. Always thinking about keeping that perimeter on the very top layer nice and round. So back to work. Another way to make sure you have a clean circle when you start to dig it out with a pick is to use, it's not a fuller countersink bit, but it's just a regular countersink bit that, you know, somebody would use when they were doing cabinets. And this has a sharp enough point on it that if you get it in the middle, even maybe even make a small hole with the pick, this will go down in there and do the same as the fuller without a bit hitting that top of that screw. It will hit it and you'll feel it and you'll stop. It's also good if you want to uniform the hole if it's a little ragged. If you make a mistake or something in the past has made that hole ragged, this is probably like a number 10 countersink. So you put it in there and you just slowly let it work. It will even out that hole and make your bung and or the filler look more uniform versus a ragged, which is not good. You're gonna have those anyways, so this will help you kind of maybe eliminate a few more. I've got all of the putty out of the fastener holes on the deck and was very pleased. Not any issues until I got to the stern. Now, this is a strange looking repair, or it was done in the factory. You can see that they obviously wanted to do, you know, a scarf of some sort, or even just, you know, a connection there. But the sides are bewildering because you see a couple, there's three fastener holes and then nothing. Yet when you go on this side, same on top, very large fastener hole where they were trying to keep it together, I think. This one's very loose. So it's split and it was repaired or it was done at the factory. This makes me think in both cases that this was done in the factory, but just failed. So what I'm gonna do is remove both, re-glue them and with Titebond, and just go ahead and put them back together and I'll refasten them so there'll be a nice tight joint there so the varnish will look a lot better. So back to work. So these are factory joints. Nice groove, tongue and groove. This one slid forward, so I'm gonna re-glue it and clamp it. And I think I'm gonna clamp it without screwing it down just to give it some chance to move. And then before I do that, I'm gonna dress these bottoms. There's some bad, some old fairing compound or somebody stuck something in the back seam of the transom area. I'll get that cleaned off so it'll sit better. And I'll clean up this joint and I'll glue it there and I'll glue it here on both sides. The other one, for the life of me, I couldn't find the fastener on the top. Sanded, looked, nothing. And so what it is this reciprocating saw, oscillating tool, I mean, I just took that fastener off and it came right out. So I'll go ahead and do the same with it. Clean up the bottom, clean up the joint without messing around with the factory joint. And then I'll clamp those really tight and then tomorrow I'll put the fasteners back in. As you can see, I've filled the fastener holes with mahogany famo wood. And I've come down here and executed a repair. These two, I mean, there's two pieces of lumber here, and they probably had resorcinol glue at one time, probably 1955. There's something there, it looks like glue. I cleaned it up lightly so I didn't mess up this joint. It's a tongue and groove joint, and I just went ahead and put in some Titebond III wood glue. I didn't think it was worth epoxy, and I think the wood glue probably will look better. You could take stain better, blend it in. There was a seam there, so there will be a seam there, but went ahead and did that and used my clamps not only to bring the dovetail back in, but also to bring it down towards the transom so it stayed pretty straight. And then when that's done, I will re-drill the holes, make them a little bit deeper with the countersink so that they're a lot farther down and it'll establish hopefully new holes.
I plugged the old holes so that we could try to find new holes to, you know, to drag it back in, make for a tighter joint. So on to sanding the famo wood, and eventually I'll get back here and sand out this joint, then put some famo wood in there to just blend it in.
I'm sanding down the deck now, which on each side, the covering board and mini aft decks are solid mahogany, and I believe covered in epoxy, as was some of the keelson and floor. And it went all the way around. I didn't find it on the shear rail / rub rail that I worked on. I didn't find epoxy there, but I did find it here. So it's been here. I thought it had been bedded, but it was filleted. So I found cracks in the fillet. So it was embedded with epoxy, which would have been better. What I'll do is clean that out and then make sure I get some bedding compound in there. And then stain and varnish will follow, which will help seal it. One of the reasons why I decided to take this down was this. This here is where the epoxy failed, right down to the wood. So on top of that would have been stain, epoxy, several coats of varnish. So I would have had to fix that, which would have meant this never would have looked right. There were lots of chatter marks on that rail. I mean, it was on the top. It had a lot of abuse just from wear and tear. That's not necessarily malicious, but I went ahead and did the other one already. I'll do that one. And then I'll, when I do the deck and then the covering board, you can see they're natural. And these were stained. I'll try to do some blending here because, as you can see, it goes right into the interior, which was done natural. And that's just getting scuffed. So we'll try to get a nice transition, do the best I can, and call it good. I began sanding on the deck beyond the famo wood that I put in. I left the finish on when I was doing the famo wood fairing, if you want to call it, or filling in the fasteners, because I wanted as much finish around that fastener hole to protect it when I was hand sanding with 80 grit on my soft block. So now that I've got the famo wood portion done, I've started to sand this deck, which has epoxy on it. I wasn't sure that whoever did it, restored it last. I know there's epoxy in the interior. I did not find it on the exterior, but it appears that from the deck and the seats and everything has epoxy. So what they did is they stained it, and then instead of using sealer for stain, they used epoxy and coated it. And it looks like it did really well, except the owner and I decided that the deck was blotchy, meaning the stain wasn't evenly distributed on the plywood, which is, you know, easy to do. So I decided I wanted to try to sand it. So I first went over the entire deck with 80 grit on my orbital, and I took off the yellow varnish. I could see the powder, and that was definitely the varnish. And then you'll start to see a kind of a off blue haze or kind of a chalky surface. That's the epoxy. And then I went again, I went over it with 80 grit, and you can see from this side very carefully I was controlling the orbital and letting it float on the surface. And I worked left to right, always having the sanded portion leaving my stroke. So I always knew that I wasn't burning through, and I was always going on to epoxied surface. So I knew the backside of the sander, you can't see as well. I always know it's into some heavy epoxy, so I'm not gonna burn through. And I just slowly work my way left to right, and then my hand gets tired, I go right to left. I just making sure I always have this as my trailing edge, kind of like when you paint, it's the finished edge. So I'm going to get back to doing this. It took several hours to get this. I can't imagine what this would be like to do it by hand. And I'm almost convinced that if I used hand 80 grit, that it might be harder on it than the orbital floating. It's covering the surface with that 5-inch disc and really getting, it's not digging in and it's not finding its way into the grain. There were a few burn throughs, I call them, or where somebody went through the top layer of the veneer into the second, which is probably going in 45 degree direction. That's how plywood is made. And so what I'll end up doing is sanding that out with my pad, and then I'll grain it with some stain, hopefully, and maybe even some markers to try to simulate the mahogany grain the best I can. Those were already there. I knew it, and I'll deal with it later when I get this all done. So I'm going to get back to sanding this, and then we will be ready to do some graining fixes. There's a couple fasteners that I didn't see before that I want to get in there and fix, and I'll probably tape around those now so that I don't sand through this veneer, just the FAMO wood. So I'll get back at it. I have finished the orbital 80 grit sanding of the deck, and this is what we have. As I mentioned before, there's a few places where the previous restoration had gone through this layer and into the second layer of the plywood. So it tells you that there's not much there. So these are the ones I'm going to have to, you literally will paint it with the stain and then try to line it either with markers or graining tools. So there's not too many of them. They were under the epoxy. I could kind of see them. There's a few here too, but it's to be expected. I'm going to enjoy looking at this deck now that it's done. One last hurdle that had me a little worried. I wasn't sure if we could even save it at one point, but I'm glad it was. There was enough veneer there under the stain and the epoxy that we could get a pretty good looking deck that with gel stain from Lake Oswego Boat Company will look really good. One thing I did notice, and Brian Fogarty had told me on the website for Wagemaker Wolverines that these should have 2.5-inch spaced white lines, and I couldn't for the life of me find it. I think they had been taken out in the previous restoration, or they usually paint on top and then a couple coats of varnish and call it good. Some boat builders would put a little groove into the deck, either with a router or even a scrawl. And then, as I was sanding, I noticed little white dots, and they're all 2.5 inches apart. So Brian was right, and I was not sure, but now that I have evidence, I'm looking forward to putting those white stripes back on later in the varnish job. So I'll call that part of the restoration complete. I've got a little bit of sanding back here where I keep just working on FAMO wood in the areas that need it. And then the deck will be done and ready for stain. And then I will move on to the interior. The goal is to move to the interior, work on the seats that need to be sanded, and then work my way out of the boat onto the deck, and then possibly even the sides where I'll do the last of the varnishing. I have the ability to do almost anything I want with my lifts and being able to turn the boat anywhere I want. So that is that. So with the completion of the sanding of the deck, I'm going to call this episode closed and move on to the next part. Thank you for tuning in, and if you're enjoying the series, please hit the subscribe button. Always appreciate the likes that I've been getting. That means it's obviously resonating with some of you, and you're liking what you're seeing or what I'm doing. And I will hope to keep moving ahead on a 2-week schedule. So with that, I'll see you in 2 weeks.